Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with our scenario-independent quick missions. The next mission in hand is Mission Lifeguard, which takes place in East Asia, 11:30 hours, and there is a light amount of snow. Now, the mission scenario is simple. An F-16 pilot has been shot down near you. Proceed to the crash site and rescue the pilot before enemy forces can capture him. Now, I have played a similar mission in Delta Force 1 and it sucked in that game because, my god, you have to be lightning fast, and the only way you can be that fast and precise to take care of the enemies before they can get you or the pilots, in this case a singular pilot, is if you have replayed the mission a few times and already know where the enemies are going to be in your expected path. So not only would I have probably to find an optimal path through this level, but I'll also have to be very quick in executing the enemies as well as any other action when I take said path. Now, there is also another catch to this mission, and the fact is that near the end, you will never be able to make it quick enough to the enemy, to our F-16 pilot. And yeah, it's sort of a scripted event wherein a bad guy will be holding him hostage. And here's the thing, you need to be accurate and shoot the bad guy without shooting the hostage. And if you shoot the hostage, it's obviously game over. But if you miss, the terrorist is going to execute the pilot. And yeah, for that reason, we will actually have to command our allies to stay put near the beginning. Now, the reason I know this is because I've read both the official and unofficial strategy guides. And while the official strategy guide did not make any mention of this, the unofficial one did. And that is all I remember from the strategy guides, to be honest. So yeah, we'll have to do that for this mission.
An F-16 pilot has been downed near a remote SAM battery. The pilot has survived the crash, but he is surrounded by hostile troops. He needs immediate extraction. Proceed to the crash site and recover the pilot. Bravo will be inserted northwest of the SAM sites and is tasked with disabling the SAMs before locating the pilot. Alpha and Charlie teams will aid in the search and provide security to the extraction point. The SAM sites are moderately defended and patrols are currently searching for the pilot. Good luck.
Good luck. Now, I don't know whether I should probably like tell Alpha and Charlie to stay put after I've destroyed the SAM sites or before, but I'll try doing it before first. M4, grenade launcher, extra ammo. Now, instead of silent charges, I would like to take a law, and I don't think I would require the extra ammo. I think another pair of laws would do the trick. And I think I also have like artillery authorization for this mission, but I'm not certain. Anyhow, we begin.
Kane 6, this is Black Widow. We are in position.
Roger that, Black Widow. Break. King 6 to all elements. Destroy those SAMs and find our pilot.
Copy that. Alpha 1 in position.
King 6, this is Alpha 1. There's a patrol on the ridge just south of Bravo's insertion.
This is Charlie 1. We got a couple of snowcats moving along the perimeter.
I saw them.
Acknowledge, Charlie 1. Observe and avoid contact.
Alright, the SAM site is right in front of us, and yeah, we need to take it out. Switching to single fire mode. Now, the previous time around, a lot of the folks at the base saw me. It sort of made it difficult for me to essentially target the SAM site, but I'm hoping that this time would be a little different. I would be able to get to the SAM site more or less undetected. I see a bad guy there. No, that's just a tree, not a bad guy. Where's the SAM site? Ah, there it is. sort of missed it there. Alright, so beginning our assault on the SAM site.
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Now, this is one of those missions where we actually want Alpha and Charlie fire teams to hold their position and not come after us. That's one down. I'll aim for that one.
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
And we're all out of laser designators. The thing about the laser designator is when it shows zero, you have no more ammo remaining, which is in stark contrast to the rest of the weapons in this game. Because for those weapons, if it shows zero, that means you're on your last round of ammunition. You've got nothing more in the chamber. We are undetected thus far, which is something that I like. Okay, SAM site has been disabled. I can shoot them out, but I would rather like to avoid them for the time being. Now, where do I have to go? Alright. Alpha 1, hold position. Alpha 2, hold position. They are holding their positions, which is good. I'll just take a look at the map, and we have to head southwest. So, alright. Southwest it is. Let me just crawl for a bit, so that I don't get detected by those enemies over there. I think we're good to go from here. Yeah, the game does keep telling you where you have to go. Need to be cautious about patrols, enemy patrols I mean. Sometimes they can kill you in a flash. Objective Eagle has been destroyed. I would like to avoid it. And checkpoint Alpha. Objective Phoenix. Objective Eagle. That is what I just destroyed. And okay, checkpoint Bravo is where we need to go. There are enemies all over the place. Difficult. Checkpoint Bravo, checkpoint Charlie is where we need to go actually. Objective Eagle has been taken care of. I hope. I think there are only like 3 SAM sites in total. But yeah, for now we're just going to follow this way. And we should be coming on to Objective Phoenix right here. Which is where the pilot could be. Oh wait, there are more SAMs here. Oh no, okay. Oh well. How'd you like them apples? So...
King 6, Alpha 1, SAMs are destroyed.
Roger. Locate the pilot and proceed to the primary extraction.
Roger, King 6. So apparently the SAM site I destroyed was probably not the SAM site I had to destroy, but... Oh well, I destroyed it anyway. And I've already given Alpha and Charlie the orders to stand down for... the end game. Snowcats, I don't think would be an issue. Whatever might be an issue is inside of those tents over there. Let's hope that there's nothing there. Heading down. Might suffer some fall damage here.
This is Alpha 1. Sam's confirmed. Bravo has eyes on Sam.
I already destroyed the Sam's. What are you talking about?
Weapons free, clear to engage.
Okay, so. We need to go southeast, but we will go around this mountain here, because that is where the enemy should be lesser in number. I think whoever was there is now flat. Flattened, I mean. Should not be too much of an issue. Let me just crawl down this area, because I don't want to risk falling. Yeah. So, the thing about this game is if you fall while you're crawling, you don't suffer any fall damage. In most cases. Sometimes you do. But in most cases you don't. Just checking for enemy hostiles here. Don't see any more. There is, however, a cat. And I'm just gonna go up this hill. Go around. I don't think speed is a key here. I'm gonna go south till the middle of this mountain and then try and find a place where I can essentially secure the hostage. Reloading. that was originally the LSM site that we had to target. So even though I did what I did rather accidentally, I would say that it has worked out in my favor, and those seem to be our friendly helicopters. And we can take like a left from here at this point. Yeah, we can start heading east. Let me just set this as my waypoint then. Checkpoint Charlie. Set as my waypoint. Alright, let's see if that works. Yes, it does. It does work. Rather fabulously. But I would rather avoid cutting through the camp to achieve that. And let's just hope that while I'm running around this area, the enemies do not spot me. Let's keep heading a little forward until east is, until the objective is aligned more towards the east. Because I want to cut through all this bullshit to get there. Don't want to engage the enemies that we don't have to engage. So in some instances, the game just ruins any potential of stealth you might have by planting enemies right in front of you. And it does tend to work for the most part. Thus far, everything is good. Thus far, everything is going great. This looks like a non-negotiable face. I'll just climb up this side, since it is close to us anyway. The game, even though you are supposed to search for a pilot, the game is generous enough to highlight the pilot for you. Like, highlight the checkpoint for you where the pilot is going to be. So, yeah, I mean, it's not like we're going in totally blind into this mission. It actually helps a lot. So, where are we right now? Okay, we're here and we need to walk like 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. Ish, 550-ish meters to checkpoint Charlie. I mean, Bravo 1 runs quite fast, so I doubt it is going to take much time. That is a negotiable face down up the mountain, but what about the face down the mountain? Where can we safely descend the mountain without risking limb and life? I think this might be it. I have not taken fall damage thus far, and I'm not eager to take any either. I'll just stick to this here side then. That way, even if I fall, I will not be falling too much. I think this much fall damage should be okay. Crawling on my side. Because I'm quite certain that I am going to fall from this side, but I just hope that it will not be too damaging a fall. Like, when you're crawling, it's far more difficult for you to fall as well, but even if you do fall, you don't suffer fall damage. Which is essentially why I crawl on the faces that, you know, go down a mountain. Comparing the two sides, this side still seems to be the more slopier one. That is a more steep fall. Even though this might make the gameplay a little more lackluster, I do believe this is one of the simpler ways of solving these missions, ones that do not require as much skill. And personally, I enjoy playing it this way, because I am a stealth gamer at the end of the day. I adore stealth games, and even in games that do not have stealth, I try to play it stealthily. Case in point. So, yeah. I enjoy playing games like this. Keeping myself hidden away, approaching the objectives, taking them out, silently disappearing. Wherever possible. I'm surprised we could climb up this face, but it's a good thing that we could. Alright, climbing further up the mountain. I'm glad that there isn't an element of speed to this mission, expediency, like there was in the first game. That sort of makes this mission bearable. Because otherwise it would be frustratingly difficult, like it was in the first game. So we are approaching the target from the rear this time around, and checkpoint Charlie is there. We need to head the... Yeah, I mean, we have set it as an objective, to be honest. I wonder if the enemy will be aware of me when I approach them. Whoa, did not see that bit there. Okay, we need to be heading this way. So let's start heading this way. How far is it? Quite far, still quite far. Let's just head up the mountain. The only problem with doing things this way is the fact that you end up straying a little far from where you originally intended to go, just because you have to find negotiable faces that you can climb and get down from. So, which I'm sort of thankful for. I mean, I'm thankful for the negotiable faces, because otherwise this game would be very difficult. Like, if it weren't for the mountains, if the entire place was comprised of flatlands, things would be very difficult in this game. So I'm sort of thankful for the fact that this game does have negotiable faces. We are near the extraction point right now, and that I do believe is the hostage that we need to take out. Enemies at 300 meters, and let's just wait for the lag to go before we go ahead and take this guy out. We are already set to semi-auto. Zooming in for 300 meters. The game is still lagging. I will not be shooting that high up. Oh, come on. Go away, lag. Why are you being such a bitch? Thank you. That guy's dead.
King 6, Alpha 1. Pod secured. We got him.
Let's just hope that I don't get shot by some random stranger or... Alright, at this point I think I should tell Alpha 1 to, no orders. No orders. Come with me. To, provide some measure of protection against any bad guys that might be here. That I cannot see thus far. So yeah, that guy was holding him hostage, and if Alpha and Charlie had reached there first, they would have essentially tried to shoot that guy, but that guy...
King 6, this is Charlie 1. Bravo has eyes on the pilot. He's okay, but he's been captured. Looks like there's only one guard.
Bravo, get him out of there.
That sounded like a shot by Alpha and Charlie. Anyhow. We need to head towards extraction. I'll just follow this pilot since he's leading the way. Apparently he knows where to go. Even though he was practically captured just a few moments ago. And yeah, there are people shooting at us. Let's just hope that I don't get shot by somebody, because my feet almost got hit right there. I don't know who's shooting at me right now, to be honest. I think it's those guys over there. Yeah, I don't want to fight them when I have lag. When I'm lagging all over the place. Okay, right now maybe? Sure. Okay, much better. I don't know where the pilot is, but hopefully he's heading towards extraction like he's supposed to. Audrey got hit once. Pretty sure the next shot is going to kill me. And that seems to be the pilot over there. Hot extraction, hot extraction. King 6, this is a hot extraction. Black Widow.
This is Charlie 1. We've got bad guys on the southern ridge.
King 6, Black Widow. We've got him.
This is King 6. Good work.
King 6, this is Bravo 1. Hostage has been secured. This is a hot extraction. We are RTB. Over and out. And that mission went smoother than I had anticipated it would. I guess I was just recalling the experiences from Delta Force 1 while playing a similar mission wherein we had to rescue hostages from a shot down F-16, or maybe it was another plane, I don't recall exactly right now at this point in time. Anyhow, I mean, this was it for Mission Lifeguard. Even though I took a more roundabout approach, I do suppose it was a better tactical choice, everything considered. And now, I had read that in the official strategy guide, that is, that you don't really need to bother yourself with the people behind you, that the Black Widow is going to sweep and then take care of them. I mean, I did see extra Black Widows on the map, so I guess that's what they were there for. But as far as this mission is concerned, I did not see that, and I have no idea what happened to Alpha and Charlie. The reason that you have to keep Alpha and Charlie in their place, as I probably have said before, is the fact that they will get to that point before you, invariably. And when they do, they will essentially take out they will try to take out the terrorists, but being programmed as the AI companions that they are, their shots will most likely miss. And when they do, the terrorist is just going to shoot the hostage and the mission will be instantaneously over at that point in time. So it sort of honestly becomes a toss of the die at that point. So yeah, hence we had to keep them locked in place, frozen until further notice, until we had actually eliminated the terrorist. So yeah, this was it for Mission Lifeguard. A tricky mission, but an entertaining mission though. Especially like when you try and play these games in a more sandbox fashion instead of following the objective markers the way, you know, the developers gave you the freedom to play the game. If you play it that way, the missions become quite interesting and very, how do I put it, simple to a degree. Which is a stark contrast from Delta Force 1, because over there, if you stray from the objective path too much, the game would sort of try and punish you. So that's not the case in this game for the most part. So anyhow, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Jailbreak. And yeah, until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.